A Ferris wheel has a diameter of 30 meters with a center 17 meters above the ground. It makes one complete rotation every 60 seconds. We want to graph one complete period of the graph that models the height in relation to time. Assume a writer starts at the lowest point, then find the equation of the graph using the cosine function. We also want to know what the height is of the writer at 45 seconds and at what time or times the writer is at a height of 15 meters. Let's start by diagramming our Ferris wheel. The Ferris wheel has a diameter of 30 meters and the center is 17 meters above the ground. Well, if the diameter is 30 meters, that means the radius, or the distance from a point on the circle to the center, this distance here would be 15 meters. So if the center is 17 meters above the ground and the radius is 15 meters, that means the lowest point on the Ferris wheel is 2 meters above the ground, which means the highest point on the Ferris wheel would be 30 plus 2, or 32 meters above the ground. And again, it takes 60 seconds for one rotation. So now we're going to plot points on the graph using the lowest point at time 0. After 1/4 of a rotation, or 15 seconds, or this point here. After 30 seconds, or half a rotation, which would be this point here. After 3/4 of a rotation, or 45 seconds, which is this point here, and then again at 60 seconds. So notice at time t equals 0, the writer starts at the lowest point, so the height is 2, which means the function must contain the point 0, 2, which would be here, where the y value would be 2. At 15 seconds, or this point here, the height would be the same as the distance from the center to the ground, which is 17 meters. So the function must contain the point 15, 17, which would be here. So the y value here is 17, which will actually be the midline of our function. After 30 seconds, or half a rotation, the height would be 30 plus 2, or 32 meters. So the function contains the point 30, 32, which is the high point. At 45 seconds, the writer is here, again at a height of 17 meters. So the point 45, 17 is on the function. And then finally, after one rotation, or 60 seconds, the writer is back at the bottom, 2 meters from the ground. So the function contains the point 62, which should be here. So because of the Ferris wheel, we have a circular function, and the graph would look something like this. We should recognize this as resembling the cosine function. So let's take this graph onto the next slide so that we can find the equation of this graph. I did reproduce it using some graphing software to make a more accurate graph. Again, the minimum value here was positive 2, and the maximum value was 32, with the midline here being at y equals 17. We're asked to find the equation using the cosine function, so we'll be using this form of the cosine function, meaning we'll have to find the value of a, b, d, and c based upon the transformations of the basic cosine function. So to find our equation, we'll use this piece of the graph. Because we're using the cosine function, and at t equals 0, we have a minimum value, we won't have a phase shift or horizontal shift, which means d is going to be equal to 0, which means our equation will be in the form y equals a times cosine bx plus c. Because we want a height function in terms of t, we're going to find h of t, which will be equal to a cosine bt plus c. So before we find our equation, let's review how a, b, and c affect the graph of the basic cosine function. The absolute value of a is equal to the amplitude, and a can be both positive or negative. If a is negative, we have a reflection across the x-axis. To find the value of b, 2 pi divided by b is equal to the period. C produces a vertical translation, a vertical shift. If c is positive, the graph is shifted up. If c is negative, the graph is shifted down. And we already said we don't have a horizontal shift or translation, so d is going to be 0. So going back to our graph, let's first determine the value of A. Well, the amplitude is a distance from the midline to the maximum, or from the midline to the minimum. Well, from 17 to 32 is equal to 15, the same as the distance from 17 to 2. So the absolute value of A must be equal to 15, which is actually the radius of the Ferris wheel. But because at t equals 0 we have a minimum, and for the basic cosine function at x equals 0 we have a maximum, we have a reflection across the x-axis, which means A is going to be negative 15, not positive 15. Next, the value of B is affected by the period, which we know would be 60 seconds. So 60 must be equal to 2 pi divided by B. So to solve for B, we would multiply both sides of the equation by B. That would give us 60B equals 2 pi. Divide both sides by 60. B is equal to 2 pi divided by 60, or B is equal to pi divided by 30. So we have the value of A. We have the value of B. Now we need to find the value of C. Well, notice how our midline is not the x-axis, it's y equals 17, which means our graph has been shifted up 17 units, and therefore C is equal to positive 17. And now we have all the information we need to write the equation of our function. We have h of t must equal A, which is negative 15, times cosine of B times t, which would be pi over 30 times t, or pi t divided by 30 plus 17. This equation would give us the height of the rider at any time t in seconds. Now for the next question, we're asked to find the height of the rider at 45 seconds, which means we want to find h of 45. We'll substitute 45 for t. So we'll have negative 15 cosine of 45 pi over 30 plus 17. So we'll have negative 15 times cosine of, this will be 3 pi over 2 plus 17. Well, we can determine this cosine function value from the unit circle. It's actually equal to 0, so we have negative 15 times 0 plus 17. So at 45 seconds, the height would be 17 meters. Of course, for many times it wouldn't come out so nice, but if we go back and take a look at our Ferris wheel just for a second, if it takes 60 seconds for one rotation, 45 seconds would be 3/4 of the rotation, which would be this point here, where the height would be the same as the distance from the center to the ground, which we were given as 17 meters. If this wasn't a nice trig function value, we'd have to approximate it using our calculator. And now for this last question, we want to know at what time or times the rider is at a height of 15 meters. If we look at our graph just for a moment, the height is 15 meters right here, just below 16. Notice if we draw a horizontal line at y equals 15, there are actually 2 points on the function from 0 to 60 seconds that have a height of 15 meters. Here and here. So we need to make sure that we get 2 solutions when we solve this problem. So to start, we're going to replace h of t with 15 meters and then solve for t. So we'll have 15 equals negative 15 cosine pi t over 30 plus 17. So we want to isolate the cosine function, so we'll subtract 17 on both sides. That would give us negative 2, since 15 minus 17 is negative 2. And then we'll divide by negative 15. A negative divided by negative is positive, so we have 2 15ths equals cosine of pi t divided by 30. And now we're going to take the arc cosine on both sides of the equation to help us solve for t. So we'll have arc cosine of 2/15 equals, on the right side, arc cosine of cosine pi t divided by 30 is just pi t divided by 30. And now to solve for t, we're going to multiply both sides by 30 over pi. Notice on the right side, pi over pi, 30 over 30, simplify to 1. So the right side is just t. So I'm going to write this as t equals 30 divided by pi times arc cosine of 2/15. Now from here, let's go ahead and call this angle theta, and we'll go to the calculator to determine what this angle would be. Remember, we're looking for two angles, and since the cosine function value here is positive, if we look at the unit circle, the x-coordinate would have to be positive. Therefore, the two angles must be terminal in the first and fourth quadrants. So now we'll go to the calculator. Let's make sure that we're in radian mode, which we are. So from the home screen, we're going to press second cosine for arc cosine or inverse cosine, 2/15, and enter. So one angle is approximately 1.437 radians. Let's go ahead and write that down. We'll call this theta sub 1. But again, we still have to find another angle that has the same cosine function value. Well, 1.437 radians is in the first quadrant, which would be this quadrant here, which means the other angle, where the x-coordinate is still positive, would have the same reference angle in the fourth quadrant. So this reference angle here would still be 1.437, which means the angle that we want, or between 0 and 2 pi, would have to be 2 pi, one rotation, minus 1.437 radians. So theta sub 2 is 2 pi minus 1.437. So theta sub 2 is approximately 4.846. So now the two times will be t sub 1 equals 30 divided by pi times theta sub 1, which is 1.437, and time sub 2 is going to be equal to 30 divided by pi times 4.846. So one time is going to be approximately, I've already determined this value, it's approximately 13.7 seconds. And time sub 2 is 30 divided by pi times 4.846, which is approximately 46.3 seconds. Now, if we go back and take a look at the Ferris wheel just for a moment, notice how 15 meters would be just below the center of the Ferris wheel that is 17 meters above the ground. So if we drew a horizontal line here, notice how the first time on the left would be just less than 15 seconds, which we found, and the time on the right would be just past 45 seconds, which we found as well. This explanation helps. Thank you for watching.